Hello friends, welcome to my channel Technical Arc and myself Arnob Kundu. Today I will discuss the Java program in BlueJ environment, means how to write Java programs in BlueJ environment, how compile it and how to run the program. Okay, so go to the computer screen. Hello friends, welcome to my channel Technical Arcoin, myself Arnob Kundu. Today I will discuss loop statements in Java using BlueJ IDE. Normally in Java there are three types of loops are there. One is for loop, another is while loop and another is do while loop. I will discuss one after another elaborately. Okay, and here I am using BlueJ IDE version 4.1.4. So let's start. So this is the BlueJ IDE and here we will discuss the loop statement in Java one after another. Okay, so at first we create a new class and suppose we put the class name is loop. Okay, and press OK. So this is the class file and just open the editor and delete what written into there because it is by default. And now at first we write our class loop and at first we define our main method. So public static void main and send as argument string array, string edges. Okay, and now at first I will discuss the for loop statement. Okay, so loop means iteration, means the condition is going on and on until and unless the condition is fail. Okay, if the condition is never fail, so it will called a infinite loop. Loop means it will going on and on, the iteration is going on and on a particular condition. When the condition is fails, then it terminates from the loop. Okay, so here suppose we define some variable int I comma a. Okay, and both are integer and put a value is suppose 0. Okay, now we just write the for loop for I equal to 1, I less equal to 10, I plus plus. Actually what we want to do, actually in that program we want to add the 10 numbers from 1 to 10, means 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8 plus 9 plus 10, whatever the result we want to print. Okay, so that's why the loop start from I equal to 1 and it go up to 10. Okay, and the addition is going on within this loop statement and that's why we write a equal a plus I, means every time I value is incremented and it just add with the last result. Okay, and after what we should close this for loop and after we just print the result system.out.println and just write sum equal double quote close plus a. Okay, means within the a variable the total result of addition from 1 to 10 will be stored. Okay, now what happened, at first we compile that, it is no error, and now if we run this main method, so it's print 55, means from summation of 1 to 10 the addition value or summation value is 55, and this is going on through the for loop statements, means this loop will be rotate until unless I value is 11. When the I value is 11, it just terminate and print the last stored value of a, means every time at first a value is 0, so 0 plus 1, new a value is 1, when I is 2, so 1 plus 2, 3, in that way it's going on and on, and when I is 11, the condition is fails, so it will terminate from there and print the last value of a. Okay, now I will provide the another example of the loop statement using while loop. Okay, the class name is the same, the loop is the class, and we write our logic within the main method. So same way we define some variable int I comma a. Okay, and same way we put here I value is 1 and a value is 0. Okay, means we here initialize I and a 1 and 0 respectively. Okay, now we put our while statement, means while loop statement, and as a condition we just write I less equal 10, and within that just we add what we write a equal a plus I, And after we should increment the I value, so just write I plus plus. Okay. And this is your end of while part, and this is your end of void main. But before ending, we just print the result. So just write system.out.println and just write sum equal double quote end plus a. Close it. And after we end our class loop. So compile it. This is no error. And now run the main method. And what it will output, the same output, sum equal to 55, means the same way the while loop is rotate or iterate. How much time? When the I value is 11, it just condition will fail and then it will terminate and just print the value of a. Means the for and the while actually doing the same way, but the syntax and the way of writing the code is just different, but their job is similar. This program will follow the same rule to add the 10 digits from 1 to 10 and the output will be the same, which is 55. Okay. Now we provide the example of do while loop, because we already know the for loop, already know the while loop. Now the another loop statement, which is do while loop. Okay. Should remember, while loop is known as entry level loop, where do while loop is known as exit level loop. Why? Because in the while loop, the condition is checked first, then it go to the statement. But in case of do while loop, at least one time the statement will be executed at first before checking the condition. That's why it's known as the exit control loop or exit level loop, and where the while loop is known as entry control loop or entry level loop. Okay, so same way we define some variable int I comma a. And same way we define the value for I equal to 1 and a equal to 0. Okay. Now we write the syntax for do while, just write do. And then what? We just add a equal a plus I. And then we just increment I value I plus plus. Okay. And then we write the while part. After brace, we just write while. And within parentheses, just write I less equal 10. And after, put this semicolon. Okay. So this is your end of do while, and within that main method we just print the value of the sum. So just write system.out.println, because the program will be the same as the for loop is concerned and as the while loop is concerned. Addition of 10 digits from 1 to 10. Okay. So just write sum equal within double quote and just write plus a and close it, and after close this main method. And after close this class, so compile it, there is no error. So just run this main method and just see the output will be the same, because the output for loop, while loop and do while loop the same, because the logic is same but the syntax for three different loops are different. For loop do in some different way, while loop do in different way, and do while loop also do in different way, but three loops are doing the iteration part, and the iteration is going on some condition, and when the condition is failed, then it terminates from that loop. I hope you have understood today's topic. For more videos, keep watching my channel Technical Arcoin. Thank you and bye bye. I hope that you have understood today's topic. For more videos, keep watching my channel Technical Arcoin. Thank you and bye bye.